Namaskara. Welcome to StudyIQ. I'm Shruti Bennur. This is the video on Karnataka State Current Affairs, April 2019. Pendrive courses of various government exams are available at StudyIQ. For more details, please visit official website of StudyIQ. On 6th April 2019, we all celebrated Yugadi festival. Here you are seeing the festival related images. People wear new dress, visit temples with their families. Jaggery and neem are consumed on this day, and this is Obbattu. Obbattu or Holige, this sweet is made specially for Yugadi. This word Yugadi has two different words. It's a combination of two different words. Yuga means age in Sanskrit and Adi means beginning in Sanskrit and Kannada language, which means beginning of the new year. Yuga Adi, beginning of new year. This Yugadi refers to the beginning of new year according to Hindu lunar calendar. It is also known as Chandramana Yugadi. This festival is also regarded as herald of harvest season. This festival is celebrated as New Year in Karnataka, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh states in Chaitra Masa. Chaitra Masa is the first month in Hindu calendar. And as per Gregorian calendar, usually this festival falls in the months of March and April. I have already mentioned, Yugadi is celebrated in Karnataka, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh as New Year. This festival is celebrated in many other states of our India under different names. It is celebrated as Gudi Padwa in Maharashtra state. And in Punjab, this is the harvest festival known as Baisakhi festival. I must remind you all about the bloodiest action of British rule here. People were celebrating Baisakhi festival on 13th April 1919. Please remember this year. Jallianwala Bagh incident took place. Jallianwala Bagh is the place in Punjab and firing was ordered by British officer General Dyer. Many innocent people lost their lives here. This is one of the worst political crimes of 20th century. And now by 13th April 2019, 100 years are over. Okay, coming back, this is Pothandu festival. First day of the traditional Tamil New Year, and Bohag Bihu festival is Assamese New Year. Vishu, Malayali's New Year, this is celebrated in Kerala state. Pohela Boishakh, New Year in West Bengal. Losung, New Year in Sikkim, this is celebrated in December at the end of harvesting by performing Cham dance. And in Kashmir, Navre, Kashmiri New Year celebration. Okay, let's move to the next current affair. Recently, Lok Sabha elections got over in Karnataka state in April 2019. Totally, there are 28 parliamentary constituencies in Karnataka state. Among them, 4 are in Bengaluru city. Bengaluru North, Bengaluru South, Bengaluru Rural and Bengaluru Central. All 4 seats in the city recorded a dip in voter turnout when compared to previous, that is 2014 Lok Sabha elections. Actually, after 2014 Lok Sabha election, multiple campaigns and initiatives were taken up to improve voter participation. Despite multiple campaigns and initiatives, Bengaluru did not buck the trend of low turnout. Citizens failed to vote in large numbers in 2019 Lok Sabha elections. Bengaluru rural seat, only 64.09% of its electorate exercised their franchise. Bengaluru South, 54.2% of its electorate exercised their franchise. And Bengaluru Central, this year Bengaluru Central saw least number of citizens coming out to vote with a turnout of just 50.84%. It's a massive drop of 5.27 percentage points as compared to 2014 Lok Sabha elections. See, every eligible citizen must cast his or her vote because ignorance of one voter impairs the security of all. Please cast vote with a hope. Please remember, this was the 17th Lok Sabha election. 17th Lok Sabha election, and there are 545 Lok Sabha seats. Among them, 543 are elected members and 2 are Anglo-Indians. 24.03% reservation for representatives of scheduled caste and scheduled tribes in Lok Sabha. Uttar Pradesh state has maximum number of Lok Sabha constituencies. There are 80 constituencies in Uttar Pradesh, followed by Maharashtra and Andhra Pradesh. Maharashtra has 48 constituencies, Andhra Pradesh has 42 constituencies, and Karnataka state has 28 constituencies. Coming to union territories, Delhi has maximum number of constituencies. There are 7 constituencies in Delhi. Remaining union territories have 1 constituency in each union territory. Let's move to the next current affair. Next current affair is about NIRF rankings 2019. Let us understand about this NIRF first. NIRF stands for National Institutional Ranking Framework. It's a methodology to rank institutions of higher education in India. This methodology was adopted by Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, and this was launched on 29th September 2015. NIRF methodology uses these parameters to rank institutions of higher education: teaching, learning and resources, research and professional practice, graduation outcome, outreach and inclusivity and perception. Here is the question: which institutes of Karnataka state were ranked number 1 in NIRF rankings 2019? Please remember, these are the 3 premier educational institutions from Bengaluru city. These institutes have bagged top spots in their respective disciplines. Under management category, Indian Institute of Management Bengaluru was ranked number 1. Under law category, National Law School of India Bengaluru has bagged top position. And under university category, IASC, that is Indian Institute of Science, has bagged top position. See, IIMB Bengaluru, Indian Institute of Management Bengaluru, has become the only business school — B school means business school — only B school in India to be a part of top 100 B schools globally. And it is one among the top 16 in APSC. APSC means Asia Pacific University Ranking 2019. Times Higher Education released this Asia Pacific University Ranking, and IIMB is one among the top 16 in APSC, and this is for the second consecutive year. This I have already mentioned. IIMB is ranked number 1 under management category in NIRF rankings 2019. NIRF is released by Government of India HRD Ministry. See, under law category, under university category and management category, Karnataka Educational Institutes have bagged top position in NIRF rankings 2019, but no government medical college has bagged a position in NIRF rankings 2019. There are 16 government medical colleges, and to get seats here, candidates have to clear this NEET exam, NEET, National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test. It's a medical entrance test. Many candidates clear this NEET exam and choose to study in Karnataka medical colleges. And Karnataka state produces 2,500 doctors every year. This is highest in the country. But still, no government medical college has bagged a position in NIRF rankings 2019. According to the sources, state-run medical colleges don't even meet the infrastructure criteria needed to even apply for the rankings. But private medical colleges of Karnataka state have performed better. 5 private colleges from Karnataka have been given ranks in NIRF rankings 2019. I'll just read out the names of those private medical colleges of Karnataka: Kasturba Medical College, Manipal; St. John's Medical College, Bengaluru; Kasturba Medical College, Mangaluru; JSS Medical College, MS Ramaya Medical College. These 5 private medical colleges from Karnataka have been given ranks. Let's move to the next current affair. In April 2019, Karnataka State Road Transport Corporation has won 2 awards. Which are the awards won by KSRTC? One is Hudko Award, another one is IOL Times Now Network Excellence in Road Logistic Industry in India under the category Best Passenger Transport Intercity. These are the two awards won by KSRTC in April 2019. I'll give more details about this Hudko Award here. Hudko stands for Housing and Urban Development Corporation Limited, Government of India. KSRTC has bagged prestigious Hudko Award for Best Practices to Improve Living Environment in 2018-2019. And this has been constituted by central government. 1 lakh rupees cash prize has been given to KSRTC. Why KSRTC was selected for this Hudko Award? KSRTC has got this award for its initiative to introduce city bus services at Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities. I'll try to give an idea about Tier 1, Tier 2, Tier 3 cities here. Indian cities are classified under 3 categories. Tier 3, in these cities, population will be less than a million. These are the examples of Tier 1 cities. Tier 1 cities are highly commercialized metropolises. Bengaluru, Kolkata, Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, these are the examples of Tier 1 cities of India. And Cochin, Mangaluru, Pune, Dehradun, these are some of the examples of Tier 2 cities of India. These are the smaller cities compared to Tier 1 cities, and statistically a million population. There will be a population of 1 million here. These are the regional hubs such as state capitals, and usually there will be many industries here, industrialized centers. Okay, let's move to the next current affair. Which airport won first ever ASQ award for arrivals, a category which was open to airports across the world? These are the options. You have to pick one. The right answer is Kempegowda Airport in Bengaluru. Kempegowda Airport in Bengaluru has won first ever ASQ award for arrivals, a category which was open to airports across the world. Please remember, Kempegowda Airport has become the world's first airport to secure Airport Council International's Airport Service Quality Award for arrivals and departure. Let's move to the next current affair. Karnataka government moots bridges instead of new roads in reserve forest areas. Moots means plans. Karnataka government is planning to construct bridges instead of new roads in reserve forest areas. This is one representative photograph, bridge passing through the forest. Actually, this is safe for wild animals also. Animals can move below the bridge and vehicles move on the road bridges, so there are less chances of accidents here. And construction of road. To construct a road, we need to acquire more forest land. That means we need to cut more trees to construct a road. If we construct bridges, only that portion of forest land where we set up the pillars of the bridges, only the trees present in that area are cut down. So construction of bridges causes comparatively lesser damage to the biodiversity. And this project will take off in Ragihalli near Bannerghatta National Park. Here is Ragihalli and here is Bannerghatta National Park. Bannerghatta National Park is near Bengaluru. See, totally there are 5 national parks in Karnataka state. Bannerghatta National Park is one among them. Which are the other four national parks of Karnataka state? Please write down in the comment box. Here is the next current affair. Karnataka State Pollution Control Board has installed sensor-based real-time water quality monitoring stations at Bellandur Lake, Varthur Lake and Agra Lakes in Bengaluru city. I'll show the photographs of all these three lakes. This is Bellandur Lake, one of the most polluted lake in Bengaluru city. Here you can observe the foam accumulation. And this is the second one, Varthur Lake, and this is Agra Lake. Agra Lake has been cleaned and now it looks like this. These three are the most polluted lakes of Bengaluru city. What are the main causes for this lake pollution or water pollution? Industrial waste directly entering the water bodies causes lake pollution or water pollution. So National Green Tribunal NGT has blasted the Karnataka state government agencies to take up an action to take corrective measures. So, Karnataka State Pollution Control Board has installed sensor-based real-time water quality monitoring stations at Bellandur Lake, Varthur Lake and Agra Lakes. See, whenever the pollution level rises up, these sensors, installed sensors, will provide an information in real time. Then the concerned authorities will take measure to check the pollution. Karnataka State Pollution Control Board will take action against the industries who discharge the waste into these lakes. It also alerts the local bodies to take up measures, corrective measures. The monitoring stations give data on 12 parameters like acidity level in the lake, chloride content, ammonium level in the lake. Such real-time monitoring stations are put in River Kaveri and River Krishna. But for Bengaluru, this is the first of its kind. State government has allocated Rs. 9 crore, especially to monitor Bellandur Lake, Agra Lake and Varthur Lakes. Real-time data on water quality in these three lakes will be available soon on Karnataka State Pollution Control Board website. And this initiative follows National Green Tribunal directions. Here is an information about Karnataka Pollution Control Board. This was established in 1974. Here is the next current affair. State government urged to seek water release from Koyna. Koyna is name of the river in Maharashtra state. There is a dam constructed over this river known as Koyna Dam. This is one of the largest dam. Farmers of Chikkodi have urged the Karnataka state government to request Maharashtra to release water from Koyna Dam to save their crops. The river here in Chikkodi is dry and the farmers are suffering. Sugarcane crop will be completely lost if the farmers do not get water. Farm labor are migrating to Goa for work and the women here are spending most of the day looking for drinking water and water for animals. Actually, large part of Maharashtra is also suffering from drought, but river water needs to be shared among riparian states. Drinking water scarcity is severe in 80 villages in Chikkodi subdivision. If the river course does not get any water, the situation could worsen. As per the tradition and understanding between Karnataka and Maharashtra state, around 4 TMC feet of water is released by Maharashtra every year into Krishna river course. If the release is delayed, farmers will suffer greatly. To mitigate the drinking water problem in Chikkodi town, City Municipal Council has dug 120 tube wells in the last 1 year. Now the Jilla Parishad of Chikkodi, Jilla Parishad has communicated to state government that some parts of the district are suffering from severe water scarcity. Hence, they have urged the state government to request Maharashtra to release water from Koyna Dam. This is the image of Koyna Dam. Koyna Dam is one of the largest dams in Maharashtra state. This dam is constructed on River Koyna. Please remember, River Koyna is the tributary of River Krishna. This river rises in Mahabaleshwar, a place in Maharashtra state. Which is the largest dam in India? The answer is Tehri Dam. Tehri Dam is constructed on Bhagirathi River. This is in Uttarakhand. These two are the images of Tehri Dam. This is the 8th highest dam in the world. Tehri Dam is the biggest, highest and tallest dam in India and 8th highest dam in the world. And this is an image of Three Gorges Dam. This is in China. This is 2.3 kilometers wide. That is 1.4 miles and 630 feet high. That is 192 meters high. This is the largest hydroelectric dam in the world. This is in China. Now, which is the biggest dam in Karnataka state and which is the oldest dam in Karnataka state? So, this is Tungabhadra Dam. Tungabhadra Dam is the biggest dam in Karnataka state and this is Vani Vilasa Sagara Dam. This is also known as Marikanive. This is the oldest dam in Karnataka state. Vani Vilasa Sagara Dam is constructed across the river Vedavati. This was built by Mysuru Maharajas. Vani Vilasa Sagara Dam, this is in Chitradurga district, Hiriyur Taluk. This is the most important current affair. Which species of fish found in River Kaveri is listed as critically endangered by IUCN? IUCN stands for International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. The answer to this question is humpbacked mashir fish. Please observe this image. This is humpbacked mashir fish. Scientific name is Thor Remadevi. It is also known as tiger of water. Please remember this sobriquet. It is also known as tiger of water. And this fish is found only in Kaveri River Basin, including Kerala's Pambar, Kabini and Bhavani rivers. Pambar, Kabini, Bhavani rivers are the tributaries of Kaveri River. There is another Indian species that is great hornbill. Threat to this great hornbill has increased according to IUCN. Now coming back to this fish. See, to secure the future of this humpbacked mashir fish, there should be a strong willingness and cooperation among three states, Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. Recently, a survey was conducted by Cigna 360 Wellbeing. According to the report of this survey, 82% of India's population is suffering from stress. People in age group of 35 to 49 are most affected, with around 89% reporting some level of stress. Now, what are the major causes for this stress? Major causes are here: work, health and finance related issues. These are the major causes for stress. And Bengaluru is the tech hub, India's tech hub. Many people in Bengaluru are dealing with severe stress due to the different lifestyles they have adapted to live. And this is also the reason why at least 200 people, please remember, at least 200 people suffering from stress or financial insecurity or loneliness commit suicide every month in the city, in Bengaluru city. Every month in Bengaluru city, at least 200 people commit suicide. Most of them do not talk to medical professionals, and many people are unfamiliar with how counselor will help. Many also find it hard to take out time for mental health professional. Here is the report given by World Health Organization, WHO. 17% out of every 1 lakh people commit suicide in Bengaluru, and this is highest in the country. This is followed by New Delhi and Mumbai with 10 to 12 per 1 lakh suicide rates respectively. So it is not just the middle-aged people who are committing suicide, but youngsters are also taking this extreme step. A study by National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences, NIMHANS Bengaluru, says 10% of suicides in Bengaluru are by youngsters in the age group of 10 to 14 years. Now, what is the solution to the problem of stress? Awareness and acknowledgement around mental health at schools and colleges in Bengaluru city. Many schools and colleges in Bengaluru city have counselors to create awareness about the mental health. And to help their employees beat stress, several corporate offices have introduced self-healing techniques like yoga and meditation sessions. Okay, here is an information about World Health Organization. Its headquarters is located at Geneva, Switzerland. It's a specialized agency of United Nations that is concerned with international public health. This was established in 1948. So this completes the Karnataka State Current Affairs, April 2019. Please pause the video and try to match the right answers here. These are the right answers. Thanks for liking and commenting on my previous videos. I wish you all the very best. Thank you.